Mind your decisions. I'm Presh Talwalkar. Pi, 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 pi. Write an equation that uses pi exactly 4 times and equals 0. Do the same thing for 1 and 2 and see how high you can go. For a real challenge, solve for any integer n. You can use common mathematical operations limited to the following table. These are standard functions you would find on an Android calculator. I think many people who suggested similar problems, including Tai C, Chiang, Peter, and the puzzling StackExchange community. Pause the video if you'd like to give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching to learn how to solve this problem. We'll get started with an equation for 0. Here's one of the many equations you could have written. Pi plus pi minus pi minus pi is equal to 0. From here, rather than writing formulas for specific numbers, let's write a general formula for any positive integer n. To do that, we'll solve a similar problem. How can you make n from 3 copies of 2? There's a clever solution from the Nobel Laureate physicist Paul Dirac. Here was his formula. Let's write the following. Negative log base 2 of log base 2. Now we are going to iterate the square root function a total of n times. In the end, we're going to evaluate the square root of 2. This exactly equals n. Why is that? Let's understand the formula by working through this nested square root. Recall that the square root of 2 is equal to 2 to the power of 1 half. Therefore, the square root of the square root of 2 is equal to 2 to the power of 1 over 2 squared. If we iterate the square root function a total of n times, we'll end up with 2 to the power of 1 over 2 to the power of n. This is also written as 2 to the power of negative n. We now evaluate log base 2 of this, which will be equal to 2 to the power of negative n. Evaluating log base 2 again, we get negative n. Then the opposite of negative n is equal to n. Therefore, this formula is exactly true. Now let's solve our problem with pi. One thing we can do is we can change the base of this logarithm and the argument in this nested square root to both be pi. Both of these will cancel out. We can then rewrite 2 as equaling negative cosine of pi minus cosine of pi. We thus have a valid expression that uses pi a total of 4 times. This will give all positive integers n. We can change the negative sign into a positive to get all negative values of n. But we have one problem. The logarithm function is using a base of 2. Log base 2 doesn't appear on a standard Android calculator. So how do we get around this? We'll use the change of base formula for logarithms. Log base 2 of x is equal to the natural log of x all over the natural log of 2. We'll use this formula and substitute in. We end up with the following fraction. Now here we have log base pi, so we'll again use the change of base formula. So now let's substitute that in and put everything in terms of the natural logarithm. Now we have a negative sign at the beginning, which we can cleverly eliminate by taking the reciprocal of this argument. This will make the formula a little bit easier to read. We now have a formula for all positive integers n. Then if we wanted to get all negative integers, we simply have a negative sign. You can also see that if n is equal to 0, this entire thing will actually evaluate to be 0 as well. So we have one simple formula, and it uses pi exactly 4 times. Incredible! Thanks for making Mind Your Decisions one of the best channels on YouTube. As always, thanks for watching, and thanks for your support.